This week's challenge, take a 1998 Volkswagen sedan and transform it into the world's coolest swamp boat. The rules. When completed, the monster machine must appear to be stock. The team can spend no more than $3,000 in hard cash for parts. Jesse and his crew have 7 days and nights to design, build, and race their creation. And the clock starts now.
Set it out. Hey.
What happened to Rand yesterday?
Give it a couple pumps.
It's crystal clear that the bug's got plenty of power, but will it float?
It's not gonna go down, man. It's gonna go down, it's gonna go down the ramp, out in the water, turn around and back up the ramp and out, and we coming back. And then we're done. It will work.
At last, the swamp thing rolls from the garage, ready for its first float test. But the crew has wasted valuable time, and now it's very late in the game. At a ramp in the Long Beach Marina, 2 miles from the Monster Garage, the crew prepares to roll their little treasure into the bay.
The confidence level is medium. I'm not completely positive it's going to float.
Okay. We're going to use the ball.
But that's why we're here.
I just mean the knives.
Everybody else seems to be like, no problem. But for some reason, I haven't seen it yet, so I don't believe it.
We give it some gas and see if we can.
Well, let's just see. Let's just make sure it's going to float first.
All we got to do is do it quick and get it out.
But it's 5 o'clock, just an hour of daylight left. If the swamp thing floats, the crew will have met the challenge. But if it doesn't, they'll lose.
The front is floating.
Fantastic. Looks like the swamp bug is taking to the water like a duck takes to a pond. But
it's sinking the front.
The front's going under.
Suddenly, the VW starts taking on water fast.
Easy, easy.
The front's taking on a lot of water.
See, it's all draining.
All the water went through the hood.
That open.
The water went through the hood.
The prow was engineered and designed to be permanently sealed and absolutely watertight, but water gets where water goes. Someone forgot to fill the hollow front prow with foam.
That bumper is a big cavity, you guys, and that's not full of foam like it was gonna be, so.
Yeah. We got any foam left, Chris?
I thought it was in there already. I didn't know there was no foam in it. That's what's gotta keep it up.
Just need a little more foam in the front, I believe. We'll be all right.
But there's no time for finger pointing. Just drill and pour.
That would, hold on.
Is that stuff dry yet? Let's go.
Night's coming down hard. Under headlights, the team races on.
Okay.
Easy now, easy.
Easy?
Now. Easy, there you go, you got it.
All right, Jess, all up. Come on down, man.
It's the final hour, 11:30, 11:40, 11:50, 10 minutes to midnight. This has got to be it.
Let's go slow, so make sure it comes up.
Tires come up off the...
I can't hold it no more.
Yeah.
It's going up. Get out of the water, man. Get out of the water.
That's in the water.
There it is.
That's it.
It's floating.
Now pull her up.
Rips come on back. Con. It ain't gonna sink no more. The foam does it. Did it.
Yeah, we should have pulled it in the
front. Oh, that was very
hot. Hot though, man. But that's all under that plate, man.
And you know what? My feet are still dry.
It floats. While the exhausted crew sleeps, Tom Pruitt of Damon's transforms our little white angel into a Diablo orange devil.
Do
Now it's off to the bayou for the Swamp Boat Challenge of the Century. Deep, deep in the very heart of Louisiana bayou country, Jesse James and his Swamp Beetle heads for a rendezvous with destiny. Neil Thibodeau, Ronnie's son, and his hunting buddy think they're gonna catch a mess of bass and maybe a gator or two. But unbeknownst to them, this day is gonna turn into the Swamp Boat Duel of the Century.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Big Schwag and Frankie Whiteside, once again, Monster Garage Challenge, special edition Cajun style. How you doing, Frank?
I am doing great, Swag.
Here we are, Centerville, Louisiana, ladies and gentlemen. 8-buoy challenge. The whole town is out in full force, including the fire department. It's going to be a barn burner of a race, Frank.
There's our man, Jesse. Now I got to ask you, Swag. He's the master of four wheels. He's the master of two wheels. But Swag, water? You gotta be kidding me.
And there is his competition for the day, Neil Thibodeau, the son of famous swamp boat builder Ronnie Thibodeau, and he is looking confident. Thibodeau, as well as the folks of Centerville, think they are in for a traditional airboat on airbows race. But now, they are getting their first look at the future. Jesse's 1998 VW Swamp Bug, and they are shocked. It's all about style, it's all about fabrication, and they have never seen anything like this before, Frank.
I've never seen anything like this before, Swag. Who has?
Oh, yeah, things pretty cool.
Oh, it takes an outlaw and a Cajun to put something like this together.
Frank, a little tidbit. There are only a handful of these amphibious cars in the world today. Ladies and gentlemen, as we gear up for the race, Neil Thibodeau says, I'm ready. Jesse gives him the nod, I'm ready. And the green flag is up, and they are off.
Jesse leaves his swamp boat behind and heads straight for the water.
And there's the equalizer, Frank. The gators are smelling blood, and they're getting in the water.
Look at that baby. She's in the water. And holy crawfish pie, she's floating.
Let me tell you something. I did a little research, Frank. 145 people go missing in the swamp every year, Frank. And those 16-foot gators weigh over 750 pounds.
145? I did not know that.
Right off the bat, you can see Jesse James is smart. He's smiling. He's laughing. He has already passed the second buoy, and Neil Thibodeau hasn't even got his boat off the trailer yet.
Yeah, but that nose is getting a little low in the water there. But where is Neil Thibodeau?
Neil Thibodeau having problems getting that 400-horsepower swamp boat in the water. Jesse James looking confident and cool. And finally, there is Neil Thibodeau, the boat. They're off and ready, and Jesse James passing the fourth buoy. Neil Thibodeau with his 400-horsepower big block Chevy swamp boat gets it ready to put in the water. And Jesse James, look at that. Jesse James giving the evil salute, saying, I will beat you. But he's taking on an awful lot of water, Frank. And if he goes under, not only does he have to worry about the 16-foot gators, but he's got to worry about them seven poisonous deadly snakes they got out there in Cajun country.
He's looking for dry land, Swag. Is he heading for the gator graveyard?
Jesse James putting his feet up. He thinks he is going down, Frank. He's checking all over the place.
They're coming into the final stretch. Jesse James is taking on all sorts of water. I don't think he's going to make it up the embankment.
Neil Thibodeau may come back and win this race for Centerville, Louisiana, because that water bug is waterlogged.
He is sucking a lot of swamp water there. I don't see how he could possibly get there.
And the fans are going ape shiznitty. They know it's going to be a photo finish, and there he is, Neil Thibodeau, coming out of the water. Jesse coming out of the water. It's going down to the line, the checkered flag, and there it is, Frank.
It's done. It's done. He's done it again.
Jesse James wins another Monster Garage Challenge, and the local boys are ticked off. And there it is, the Cajun nod. That's what Jesse Gator James is all about. But there's no time for crawfish, boil, or egg touffee. There are miles to go, and further challenges await in the Monster Garage.